In order to classify and identify materials of a wide variety, scientists use numbers. These numbers are referred to as physical constants, and some of these physical constants include density, boiling point, melting point, and so on. And these are all characteristics of the material that is always in question. Today, we shall talk about one of those physical constants, and that is density. So, what exactly is density? Density is simply the measure of compactness of matter. This is our beaker, right? Let's put in some cotton. Now, the density of this cotton, the measure of compactness of this cotton is low. It means the density is low. So let us put there more cotton and compact it. So we've put more cotton inside this same beaker. We've put there more cotton, but it is still the same volume. It's still the same beaker, but it is containing more cotton. Now, what's the analogy here? The thing is, before there was less cotton, and but the cotton was filling up the entire beaker before. Before the cotton was filling up the entire beaker, but it was less. When we compacted the cotton, we find that we were able to fill the beaker with more cotton, but still the same volume. So in essence, density is simply the measure of compactness of matter, or to be more accurate, to give a more accurate description, density is the mass per unit volume of the substance. In our first instance, when you put in very little cotton, the amount of mass per unit volume was less, because there was little cotton per unit volume of the beaker. But when we added in more cotton, it means the amount of cotton or the mass of the cotton per unit volume of the beaker increased. So when the mass of cotton per unit volume of the beaker increased, it means that the density of the cotton increased. At first, the mass of the cotton per unit volume of the beaker was less, so the density was less. So that basically is density, the mass per unit volume of a substance, and its SI unit is kilograms per meter cubed. It comes from kilogram, because mass is kilogram divided by volume, which is meters cubed, which is kilograms per meter cubed, or mass, which is grams, divide that by volume, which is centimeters cubed. Grams per centimeters cubed is right there. So it can either be this or that. One of those two is the SI unit of density. Calculate the density of a substance given that the mass is 24 grams and the volume is 36. So we say that density is going to be mass over volume. That's going to be our mass is 24 grams over our volume, which is 36 centimeters cubed. So this is going to be 2 over 3 grams per centimeters cubed. Calculate the mass of X whose density and volume are that and that. We know that density is going to be equal to mass over volume. They're telling us to calculate the mass of X, so we are looking for the value of M, which is the mass, whose density and volume are 1.2 grams per centimeters cubed. So the density is 1.2 grams per centimeters cubed. That's going to be equal to mass, which you're looking for, let's call it its X, over the volume. Our volume is 40 centimeters cubed. When we make X the subject of the formula, X is going to become 40 times 1.2 grams per centimeters cubed. And our answer is going to be 48. So it's going to be 48 grams. They're telling us right here that a box has dimensions of 4 centimeters, 3 centimeters, and 10 centimeters, and a mass of 480 grams. Calculate the density. Now we know that density is going to be equal to mass over volume. What is our mass? They've told us that the mass of the box is 480 grams, so it's going to be 480 grams. Divide that by our volume, they have just given us the dimensions of the box. The box is like this. And they've told us the dimensions are 4 centimeters by 3 centimeters by 10 centimeters, length, width, and height. So it means the volume is going to be length times width times height, which is 4 times 3 times 10. And this is supposed to give us centimeters cubed. So our answer is going to be cubed. This brings us to the end of this video. Thanks for tuning in. For more of these videos, I encourage you to subscribe to this channel. This is Arnold Rangakuramia for Kisembo Academy.